Welcome to the front line of the Army's most transformative leap in ground combat, where human ingenuity blends with machine precision to redefine the future of warfare. For generations, our soldiers have dominated the battlefield through strength, skill, and strategy. Now they stand on the threshold of a new era, one driven by robotics, autonomy, and artificial intelligence. This is the story of the Robotic Combat Vehicle, or RCV, an ambitious quest to revolutionize how America fights and wins. The vision for the Robotic Combat Vehicle, RCV, it all began with the Army's Next Generation Combat Vehicle Program, a forward-thinking initiative poised to replace and enhance today's aging vehicle fleets. At the heart of this program lies the RCV, an unmanned ground system designed to support, protect, and empower our soldiers. Think of the RCV as the Army's eyes and ears out on the front, a remote-controlled scout or autonomous partner pushing into dangerous territory ahead of manned vehicles. Picture a battlefield divided into three crucial lines: the forward line of sensors, FLOS, the forward line of robots, FLR, and the forward line of troops, FLOT. The FLOS, made up of unmanned aerial vehicles and advanced sensors, scouts well ahead of the main formation, detecting enemy positions and relaying this vital intelligence up the chain. Next comes the FLOR, the RCVs themselves, advancing into no man's land. Historically, this open expanse has claimed countless lives and vehicles, but with unmanned systems at the front, the squadron gained a critical edge. These robots not only drew the first round of enemy fire, but also located hidden threats for the main force. Finally, the FLOT, the troops, moved in under the protective envelope provided by the RCVs. By the time soldiers made direct fire contact, the enemy was already engaged by the robots, artillery, and other support elements. This layered approach minimized risk and preserved combat power for when the fighting got up close and personal. The original three variants. Originally, the Army imagined three RCV variants, light, medium, and heavy, each built for specific combat roles. RCVs were to flank manned tanks, drawing enemy fire and uncovering ambushes. They'd help preserve lives by going where it's too risky for soldiers. And if the technology proved reliable, one operator could oversee multiple RCVs from a safe location, thanks to breakthroughs in ground navigation and AI. This concept was as daring as it was practical, promising a new dimension of safety and lethality on the battlefield. From the start, the Army wanted a family of robotic vehicles tailored to different missions. RCV Light, RCV-L. Weighing in at a maximum of 10 tons, the RCV-L was designed for rapid deployment by helicopter. It has modest onboard weapons for self-defense, like anti-tank guided missiles or recoilless rifles, yet it's labeled expendable, meaning the Army expects it might be lost in high-intensity combat. Mobility is the RCV-L's key advantage, allowing it to dash quickly across the battlefield to protect manned vehicles or probe enemy lines. RCV Medium, RCV-M. At 10 to 20 tons, the RCV-M strikes a balance between firepower and transportability, capable of fitting inside a C-130 cargo plane. It boasts heavier armaments than the light variant, giving it the ability to engage light to medium armored threats. It's considered durable, less expendable than the RCV-L, reflecting the Army's desire for a more survivable platform that can hold its own on the front line. RCV Heavy, RCV-H. At 20 to 30 tons, the heavy variant was envisioned as a robust, tank-like vehicle that two C-17s could transport. Armed with advanced direct-fire weapon systems, it would challenge even the heaviest enemy armor. It's classified as non-expendable, underscoring the Army's commitment to maximum survivability, akin to any crewed tank. Collectively, these three RCV variants signaled the Army's ambition to use robotic vehicles in every echelon of ground warfare, from fast reconnaissance to full-scale armored assault. Early program status. Even in the earliest stages, the Army recognized that adopting an entirely new class of combat vehicles required fresh thinking. Instead of traditional contracts, they turned to other transaction agreements, or OTAs, which allow more flexible, iterative experimentation. The goal? To figure out what technologies are truly ready and which concepts need more development. By January 2020, the Army awarded OTAs to Chinetic North America and Textron, paving the way for prototype RCVLs and RCVMs. This bold, hands-on approach let the Army collaborate with industry partners more directly, refining requirements as testing progressed. If the experiments showed promise, the Army could scale up to a formal program. If not, they'd recalibrate, protecting taxpayer dollars and ensuring soldiers only get equipment proven to work. Shifting focus to RCV-L. By August 2023, the Army adjusted its strategy. Leaders decided to focus first on the RCV Light, reasoning it was the most straightforward path toward fielding a robotic vehicle. Lessons from RCV-L's design and testing would then feed into medium and heavy variants, or alternative approaches down the line. Army leadership emphasized the importance of putting even a limited capability robot in soldiers' hands sooner rather than later. The theory is simple. Feedback from real users in realistic training events is invaluable. For RCV-L, that training includes scenario-based exercises where soldiers work alongside these unmanned vehicles, gauging their performance, reliability, and survivability. The common chassis approach. Fast forward to 2025, and the Army strategy looks different once again. No longer do they want three distinctly separate vehicles. Instead, they're embracing a single adaptable chassis, a common platform that can be tailored to different missions. Part of this decision stemmed from lessons learned on cost efficiency, logistics, and interoperability. Cost efficiency. Developing one core design cuts down on repeated expenses for separate prototypes, parts, and tooling. Logistics. Maintaining and supplying one platform simplifies training, spare parts, and repairs. Interoperability. A single chassis means consistent software and hardware architectures, making it easier to upgrade each RCV as technology advances. Under this new plan, the Army is merging concepts from the RCV Medium design with a flexible chassis that can swap payloads and modular systems. Two parallel development efforts, a middle-tier acquisition rapid prototyping, MTA-RP project, and a specialized software acquisition pathway, SWP, will shape what this common vehicle ultimately looks like. Ongoing testing and the road ahead. In late summer 2024, four industry teams, MCQ, Textron Systems, General Dynamics Land Systems, and Oshkosh Defense, sent their prototypes to the Army for a grueling best-of-breed competition. Each team brought its vision for integrating sensors, weapons, autonomy, and communication networks into a single robotic platform. The Army aims to field the first fully operational RCV unit in fiscal year 2028 after a production decision scheduled for 2027. In the meantime, testing never stops. Soldiers are already training with early prototypes at the National Training Center, examining how these machines handle real-world conditions, deep sand, rugged hills, urban obstacles, and more. Yet the Army acknowledges the technology isn't perfect. Off-road autonomy remains a major challenge. Even the most advanced systems can struggle with unexpected terrain or obstacles, often forcing human operators to step in. But as one Army official stated, the only way to make breakthroughs is to put these RCVs in the field and see what fails. By iterating in real time, the Army believes it can refine autonomy software and correct weaknesses faster than any purely theoretical approach could achieve. Industry concerns and Army responses. Such a cutting-edge effort inevitably sparks heated debate. Some industry partners worry that the Army's so-called piecemeal strategy, selecting separate subsystems like sensors, communication links, and autonomy modules, may cause integration headaches. They urge the Army to consider a more unified approach, ensuring each component is engineered from the ground up to work together seamlessly. Another sticking point involves the Army's in-house autonomy software, once called Robotic Technology Kernel, RTK, and now known as the Autonomous Robotic Control System. Industry leaders say it's difficult to perfect, and integrators might have their own, potentially better autonomy solutions. Army officials respond that they do remain open to commercial innovations, but prefer to anchor the system in a common government-owned software baseline. They believe that learning by doing is pivotal. Field the vehicles, observe how the code holds up, then iterate toward a robust, soldier-approved design. Congressional oversight. The debate doesn't end with the Army and industry. Congress has its own priorities and concerns. Lawmakers on the Senate Armed Services Committee have specifically questioned the Army's balance between nurturing a government-developed autonomy software and tapping into the broader ground autonomy industrial base. They want to ensure taxpayer dollars are spent wisely, and they expect the Army to leverage the best and brightest minds in the commercial sphere. All of this oversight underscores the RCV's significance and the high stakes for national defense. Robotic combat vehicles represent not just another procurement program, but a radical shift in how the Army fights. When it comes to robotics, success or failure could impact everything from casualty rates on the battlefield to America's global military standing. challenges, and future outlook. No revolutionary technology arrives without hurdles, and the RCV is no exception. The Army is grappling with complex autonomy, especially in off-road environments, where muddy roads, dense foliage, and hidden obstacles challenge even the smartest sensors. Plus, real-world conflicts in places like Eastern Europe offer insights into how unmanned ground vehicles fare under fire. Reports suggest these vehicles can be incredibly effective for reconnaissance and targeted strikes, but they're also vulnerable to electronic warfare and determined adversaries. The Army is watching, taking notes, and adjusting its RCV roadmap accordingly. As they look toward 2025, they'll down-select to a single vendor, awarding further prototype development to refine both hardware and software. By fiscal year 2028, the Army hopes to field an RCV that's battle-ready, enabling soldiers to fight smarter, faster, and with far fewer risks to human life. Through all the tests, the setbacks, and the innovations, one truth rings clear. The Robotic Combat Vehicle Program isn't just about creating a new machine. It's about shaping a new battlefield where man and machine work side by side to secure victory. With each step forward, the Army blazes a trail into a future where the speed, precision, and intelligence of robotics redefine what's possible in modern warfare. This is the dawn of the robotic combat vehicle, a testament to American ingenuity and the unbreakable spirit of those who stand ready to defend our nation.